your Richland Bombers. The Lions entered today's game with a 7-1 record. The Bombers entered today's game with an 8-0 record. Today's game will be conducted under the rules and regulations of the MCC and the WIAA. All spectators in our jersey group for their team are asked to display good sportsmanship towards opponents and officials. Spectators who make harassing comments, including those of a racial or sexual nature, will be removed from the field. We'd like to remind you that the Richland School District is a tobacco-free school district. Tobacco products and alcohol beverages are not permitted on school property. Signs other than the official school ban on the use of any type of noisemakers are strictly prohibited. We hope you will enjoy today's contest and support our efforts to protect human dignity by promoting good citizenship and sportsmanship in high school interscholastic athletics. Attention fans, you have friends and family who want to follow along but can't be here today or live out of town? Well, the game is being broadcast live on YouTube by our Best in Class Atomic TV program. To watch the game, head to YouTube.com and search for Atomic TV and join Mr. Tim Ryan for all the action. On deck, a Tuesday night tilt, Lions, Bombers, next. Ladies and gentlemen, this time we ask you to please rise and remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Atomic TV's live coverage of Mid-Columbia Conference Baseball here live from Bomber Field on the campus of Richland High School. I'm Tate Meyer. On the camera today is Jared Meyer. We'll bring you all the action today live from Bomber Field as the Kennewick Lions come into today's game at 7-1, having been defeated only by the Richland Bombers thus far this season. And they battle the Richland Bombers with a perfect 7-0 record entering today's contest.
Michael Ravel.
On the bump today, we have the sophomore, Michael Ravel, number 26. 8 innings pitched so far this season. 2 hits given up, no runs, 2 walks, and 7 strikeouts so far this season. The sophomore gets the start. And he will face a lineup for the Kennewick Lions. First, let's give you the lineup for the Richland Bombers. Around the diamond, Chris Daniels starts at third base. Carter Upmeyer at short. John Corbin at second base. Dallas Bennett at first. Hayden Galloway behind the plate. Brody Bosick in left. Race Reeves in center field. And John Simons in right field. Again, Michael Ravel on the bump. For the Kennewick Lions, Dane Chavez will lead it off. He'll be pitching for the Kennewick Lions today for Lenny Ayers in his 9th season at the helm of the Kennewick Lions with a 119-47 overall record. Dane Chavez, Dane McClure will follow him. He'll be his catcher for today. Salisbury, Mamiya, Mattson, Long, Driver, Taylor, and the other Chavez brother, Dierks at shortstop. We'll get it underway here. The Bombers and the Lions, longtime rivals going back to the early 1900s. Renew their rivalry today here from Bomber Field. As Ravel winds and fires, 4:58 first pitch. Game time temperature 62 degrees live from Bomber Field. Sunny day so far. As Chavez fouls it off. Ravel winds and fires again, the 1-1 in there for a strike. 1-2 the count now on Chavez. Chavez batting 370 on the year, 10 for 27. Has four doubles and four RBI. The fourth pitch from Ravel, high and outside for a ball. Ravel from the windup, I'm gonna deliver the 2-2. Inside, but behind the plate umpire, Greg Mitchell says no, that's a ball. And it'll fill the count up at 3-2. The payoff pitch, fouled away again to the left side. Over the batting cages and into the tennis courts. So still 3-2 count now on Chavez. Ravel winds and fires and low for ball four. So the first batter of the day gets on for the Kennewick Lions. And I'll bring up number three, the catcher, Dane McClure. Dane McClure, 8 of 23 on the season, 3.48 average. Four walks, four strikeouts, five RBI, and eight runs for the senior. Bell's first pitch just outside. Another one fouled straight back over the press box. 1-1 the count now on McClure. Well, from the stretch now, pickoff attempt over to first. Chavez back in time. Chavez brothers, both juniors, number two and number four. Number two will be Dane, number four will be Dierks. And when Dane is not pitching or Dierks isn't pitching, they'll play second base and shortstop respectively. A ball outside, 2-1 count now on McClure. Runner goes, but fouled away. 2-2 now on McClure. Dane Chavez over at first. Six stolen bases on the year. Tried to add a seventh there, but Dane fouled it away. The 2-2 pitch again from Ravel. Swinging strike three, so Ravel gets his eighth strikeout of the year, and McClure will sit down, and that will bring up Connor Salisbury. Salisbury, the senior infielder, 391 on the year, 9 of 23 this season, 12 RBI, 7 runs. Ball outside, ball one. The Kennewick Lions had their winning streak over the Richland Bombers snapped over in Kennewick on the 19th. The Bombers taking that game by a score of 7-4. The first time the Bombers had defeated the Lions since 2019, April 26, 2019. As that is a ball low of the zone. Richland won by a score of 1-0 in 2019 over in Kennewick at Roy Johnson Field. So it's been a while. These two exchanging MCC championships. The last two belonging to the Kennewick Lions. In 2021 and 2019 to the Richland Bombers. And that. Umpire's now discussing whether it was a balk, and they'll say it was. Did not step off before he attempted to throw to second. So one out, one on. That runner going up to second on the balk. Catcher Hayden Galloway and shortstop Carter Utmeyer out to talk to him. Settling down a bit. Again, we also have Mid-Columbia Conference softball here on Atomic TV. It's being streamed live also on this YouTube channel. Hop back out to the main page and we'll see the Lady Bombers taking on the Southridge Suns in the return trip of a home and home series. They won that game last week by 10 runs. That pitch high and outside. Ball three, 3-0 count now on Salisbury. We apologize for our transmission from center field being a little bit choppy. I think it'll clear up here soon. So 3-0 count now from Revelle to Salisbury. That one high in the zone though. Strike one. Revelle the 3-1, fouled away over to the Fran Rich parking lot. Hopefully not too many cars parked in close proximity. So a 3-2 count now. Pitch count going up for Carter or Michael Revelle in his first inning work. Winds and fires. Ball four for runners on first and second base now for the Lions. Bring up Dylan Mamiya for the Lions, sophomore outfielder and pitcher. 278 on the year, 5 of 18. 6 RBI, 11 runs. One of their main pitchers this season, along with the junior Cameron Owen. Mamiya started against the Bombers over at Roy Johnson Field. Went 3 innings, 4 hits, 4 runs, 3 earned. And unfortunately took the loss. That one off the netting for strike one. Bombers face the lefty in Mamiya over at Roy Johnson. We'll face Chavez here in the bottom half of the inning. Bell looks back at Chavez at second. Winds and fires. Breaking ball doesn't break enough. Ball one to Mamiya. Revelle from the stretch again, just outside again. 2-1 count now on Revelle as he works through early trouble here in the top of the first. See Chavez with a healthy lead at second. John Corbin walks over, pats his glove. Revelle winds and fires. And that's chopped right back up the middle to Utmeyer. Utmeyer bobbles it a little bit, tag second, throws to first, not in time. So gets the second out of the inning at second. But Mamiya beats it out on the fielder's choice. And there's runners on first and third. For Brady Mattson, another sophomore for the Lions. One of the storylines coming into today's game, sophomore reinforcements for both of these squads. Mamiya, Mattson, Curtis, Dominic Driver, Chase Taylor for the Lions. For the Bombers, one of those sophomores being Ravel. That first fouled away. Ravel, Braylon Edwards, Hayden Galloway, Brody Bosick. All very good sophomore reinforcements for both of these squads. Brady Mattson, 462 to start the season. 0-1 in there for strike two. Six for 13 on the season for Mattson. Five RBI, six runs on the air. Stretch, runner goes to second. No throwdown. He'll Galloway, that is. Let the runner go to second. Take the first ball of the at-bat. 1-2 count now on Mattson. Trying to make something happen for the Lions. Ravel trying to prevent it. The 1-2 outside evens the count up at 2. The Lions hitting 347 on the year, averaging 9.5 runs a game, 9.4 hits per game. Most of their decisions by 10 or more runs. 2-2. Chopped down the third baseline in foul territory. And we'll re-rack it, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Kennewick started off with wins over Capital, West Valley, Ellensburg, Mount Rainier, Skyview, scoring 10 or more runs in all of those matchups. And recently on Friday, defeating Pasco in a twin bill, the 2-2. And Mattson will wear it. And the bases will be loaded for Ravel here with 2 outs.
Coming to the plate, PH number 12, Devin Long.
Devin Long approaches the batter's box for the Lions. The junior, 333 on the year. Four RBI and 8 runs scored. Excuse me, 3 runs scored. Ravel continues the battle from the stretch. Bases loaded, 2 outs for the sophomore early on. Ball low and away, says Greg Mitchell. Ball 1-2, Devin Long. Well, second pitch in there, strike one. Evens the count up at 1. Michael Ravel also adding to the Bomber barrage offensively, 357 on the year in the batter's box. It's the 1-1 through the bat of Long for strike two. 1-2 now on the junior. Long steps in, Ravel gathers, and the 1-2 pitch in the dirt away for ball 2, and we're back to an even 2-2 count. Ravel already with 31 pitches, his first inning of work. The 2-2 to Long. Outside corner, clips it enough for strike three. And Long is sat down and no damage done for the Bombers. The bases are loaded, but nobody comes across. No runs, no hits, no errors. 3 men left on base. The Bombers will be coming up for their first steps of the game when we come back right here on Atomic TV. We'll be right back.
out for Kennewick, number two, Dane Chavez.
To Mid-Columbia Conference Baseball here live on Atomic TV. As we enter the bottom of the first inning, the Kennewick Lions did not come up with any runs in the top. As we enter the bottom, the Bombers will be having their ups here in the bottom of the inning. We'll take a look at their lineup. They'll be leading off will be Carter Ruttmeyer at short. John Corbin will be in the second slot. Chris Daniels batting third. Batting fourth will be Dallas Bennett, John Simons, Michael Ravel. Hayden Galloway, the sophomore, leading the team with a .583 batting average. He'll be batting in the seven hole. Brody Bosick and Race Weaves will round out the lineup for Grant Richardson in his 11th season at the helm of the Bombers. Richland graduate of 2001, 162-85 total. His record so far, and of course, the 2018 4A state title. So enter the bottom half of the inning. First pitch from Chavez in there for strike one. Upmeyer batting .368, 7 of 19 so far on the year. Breaking ball, low in the zone, in the dirt, in fact, for ball one. Richland sitting atop the MCC standings as of today. Tied, as that one's fouled away, tied with the Kamiakin Braves at 7-0 overall and 3-0 in league play. Again, the Kennewick Lions only lost to the Richland Bombers back on the 19th. They sit in second. Chopped up to the shortstop from Upmeyer. Upmeyer will not beat it out in time. That's Chavez to Taylor on the putout for the Lions. John Corbin will be stepping into the batter's box now for the Bombers. The senior struggling so far this season, 182 on the year. At this point last year, batting .474 as he takes ball one. Despite the drop in batting average, though, still producing 7 RBI, the same amount he had at this point last year. He swings through that one for strike one of the AB. He and Chris Daniels kind of opposite, 3 and 4 hitters traditionally for the Bombers, but still producing 15 total RBI among the two as he fouls that away for strike two. See if Corbin can put one in play here for the Bombers. Chavez worked quickly. Breaking ball doesn't break enough into the zone for ball two. 2-2 count now. Bombers batting .320 as a squad, averaging 8.5 runs. That ball is outside. 3-2 count now on Corbin. Corbin second on the team in walks with 4. He hits that one to the right side, just under the glove of Taylor. And Corbin will start the day off with a single for the Bombers. Solid piece of hitting opposite way for Corbin to get on base first. You heard me talk about how the Bombers play offense at all these past 3 seasons. They like to play small ball, they like to run the bases. 3 stolen bases for Corbin so far this season of 12 total. Chris Daniels takes that first pitch for a ball. Chris Daniels, .316 on the year, 6 of 19. He takes that ball in the dirt, ball two. Again, 8 RBI and 5 runs for the senior third baseman. 3 sport athlete at Richland. Dane from the stretch fires. Strike on the outside part of the plate. 2-1 the count now on Chris Daniels. No action so far with Corbin at first. Swings through that one, does Daniels. 2-2 count now on number 10. Daniels has the only home run for the Bombers this season. Straight away to center field on a windy day. 2-2, ball outside, 3-2 count now. And with the wind, that ball was launched to straightaway center in the old irrigation canal. Would have been a home run either way. Dane Chavez, the 3-2. Daniels fouls that away to the right-hand side, and Corbin will return to first base. Again, traditionally last season, Corbin and Daniels were in the 3-4 slot. They move around a bit, but still in the upper half of the lineup. The other 3-2, Daniels hits that one to right center field. And Corbin trips over second base a little bit, but a single will move Corbin over to third, and the 3-4 hitters for Richland producing early here in the ballgame. We'll bring up Dallas Bennett, the senior pitcher and first baseman, today playing first base, but one of the two main arms for the Bombers, as the signals given out by Dane McClure for the Lions about what they want to do here in this first and third situation. Dallas's first pitch from Chavez, high and outside, ball one. Dallas Bennett, 333 on the season in 7 games, 6 of 18, 5 RBI and 4 runs. That ball high above the zone, ball 2, 2-0 count now on the senior. Again, Bennett, one of the two main arms for the Bombers, 11 innings pitched, 6 hits, and a .64 ERA. He hits that one in left field, and that will score Corbin for the first run of the game for the Bombers. The Bombers get the bats going early and score Corbin from third off the bat of Bennett.
Now batting, right number 2, John Simon.
And that will bring up John Simons, the senior right fielder for the Bombers. Dallas Bennett's 6th RBI of the year drives in Corbin early. And we have runners on first and second for Simons. 467 on the year, 7 of 15 for John Simons. 7 RBI, 7 runs scored. First pitch from Chavez is outside for a ball. Chavez winds and fires again. That one high in the zone, popped up towards the right-hand side of the field. Hovering under is Driver, and he will make the second out of the inning on the pop-out by Simons.
Stepping in, the pitcher number 26, Michael Ravel.
Sophomore number 26, Michael Ravel, stepping into the batter's box, trying to aid his own cause with 2 out here in the bottom of the first. First pitch outside for a ball, as I said, at the top of the inning. Sophomore reinforcement batting 357 on the season, 5 of 14 on the year. Second pitch from Chavez in there for strike one. So Chavez's first earned run given up of the season. 7 innings pitched, 3 walks on the year, 11 strikeouts. 3 hits now and 1 earned run for Dane Chavez. The 1-1, high and outside, ball 2. Both of these teams trying to get back to the Final Four, the state tournament. Both teams losing at the regional round at their home fields. Want to remove that sour taste in their mouths from 2023. As Ravel takes a ball, 3-1 count now on the sophomore. Three-one pitch now. Outside, that'll be ball. That'll be clipping the zone for strike two. Didn't see an immediate sign from umpire Greg Mitchell, so full count now on Ravel. 3-2 pitch. Swinging, strike three, and Chavez sits down Ravel to the end of the inning. So one run, three hits, no errors, and two men left on base. We'll come back for the top of the second here from Bomber Field when we come back here on Atomic TV. Welcome back to Bomber Field for Mid-Columbia Conference Baseball here live on Atomic TV. The Kennewick Lions coming up in the bottom half of the sixth inning. Dominic Driver will lead off for the Lions. He chops one to third. Chris Daniels just in and out of the glove. He'll throw it over to first, not in time, and draws the first baseman Bennett off the bag, trying to make up for the error, but that'll be an error for Chris Daniels, and Dominic Driver will reach on error to lead off the inning. Looks like head coach Grant Richardson wants a little bit of an explanation. Further discussion, the umpire is agreeing that he did step on base and he is safe, so we'll move on. Chase Taylor now stepping in for the Lions. Sophomore infielder, 333 on the year, playing second base today. 7 of 21 thus far. So Ravel from the stretch delivers, and it's fouled into the batter's box for strike one. So the 0-1 from Ravel in the dirt, ball one, evens the count up. Hayden Galloway posturing towards first like he wanted to get Driver back. Heads back anyway. 1-1 the count now on Taylor. Taylor pops one up straight away center field. Race Reeves will hover under it and squeeze it for the first out of the inning. I'll bring up the number 9 hitter for the Kennewick Lions, Dirk Chavez. The junior for the Kennewick Lions. Derek's hitting 381 on the season, 8 for 21 on the year. Swings through that one, fouls it away for strike one. The 0-1 pickoff attempt over to first. Not in time. And trying to solve our transmission issues from our center field camera. We appreciate your patience. The 0-1 pickoff attempt over to first. Not in time to get Taylor at first base. Sorry, Driver at first base. He was off a long way. And Hayden Galloway, excuse me, thought he could get him, but he could not. And it'll be a 1-1 count as Derek Squares does not deliver the bunt. Two and one count now on Chavez. Looks like we have our transmission issues solved. He fouls that one off in the foul territory left side. Not in time to get it is Daniels from third base. Wind blowing a little bit from the Franrus Stadium parking lot out toward the hospital, Cadillac Regional Medical Center. Left center field from Bomber Field, as it normally does, the prevailing winds. So back where we started here, 2-2 count on Chavez. Stepping off is Ravel. Chavez again awaits the 2-2. Ravel steps off again. Kennewick Lion fans want to balk, but I don't think they're going to get it this time. Lenny Ayer is making some arguments towards Greg Mitchell, not winning that argument. The ball is in the dirt, 3-2 count. Now on Chavez. Runner goes into right field, shallow right field. Coming in to catch it, actually going out to get it is John Corbin. He'll make the squeeze and the second out of the inning. Thought John Simons might get there first, but Corbin floating out to right and getting the second out of the inning. Now Dane Chavez, the pitcher, brother of Dirk Chavez. Again, both juniors, number 2 and number 4. Dane, the pitcher in this one with 2 outs here. Right back up the middle. That'll be through the glove of Upmeyer into center field for a base hit. Hard hit ball right back up the middle. And we have runners on first and second now for the Lions.
Coming to the plate, catcher number 3, Dane McClure.
Hard hit ball off the pitching rubber, it looked like. And then bounced high enough just out of the reach of Carter Upmeyer into shallow center. In steps Dane McClure now. McClure 0 for 1 in today's game. Pitch from Ravel outside, ball 1. Two out here in the top of the first for the Lions. And for Michael Ravel, 46th pitch on the way. That one high in the zone and a high pop up to left field. Hovering under it is Brody Bosick, and the sophomore grabs it for out number three. So no runs, one hit, no errors, and two men left on base for the Lions. The Bombers heading up to the plate next here on Atomic TV. Welcome back to Bomber Field here on the campus of Richland High School. More Mid-Columbia Conference baseball here live on Atomic TV. Scoring update from Columbia Playfield across the way. The Bombers 7, the Southridge Suns 4 at the top of the third inning. The Lady Bombers trying to stay undefeated, as are the baseball Bombers here at Bomber Field. Hayden Galloway leads us off here in the top of the third inning. He hits that one into left center field, a beautiful single to lead off the inning for the Bombers. Told you Hayden Galloway led the team with a 583 batting average, and that batting average going up now with his single to left. And that'll bring up Brody Bosick. Brody Bosick, the sophomore left fielder, made the final out of the top of the second. He swings and fouls that one into the netting. Bosick again, sophomore, 333 on the season, 2-for-6. But of those two hits, 4 RBI for sophomore. Ball getting underneath McClure, but no runner going on behalf of the Bombers, as Easton Prano in courtesy run for Hayden Galloway doesn't take off. Easton Prano, the main pinch slash courtesy run for the Bombers. He'll take off here and get caught in the middle. He'll go way back to first base, as the ball didn't quite get as far away from McClure as Prano thought it did. And he'll scurry back to first. Again, Prano, the main pinch slash courtesy runner, 7 runs scored on the season. Bosick lines that one into right center field, and that will go all the way to the fence. Bosick will take 2. Prano will come around third, and he will head home. The throw from the track to the short will not be in time, and the Bombers will take a 2-0 lead on a triple from Brody Bosick. So Brody Bosick tripling in a run to make the score 2-0 Bombers. Only the second triple of this young season for the Bomb Squad. Hayden Galloway owns the other one, had that one in Walla Walla this past weekend as a part of a shellacking of the Blue Devils. The Bombers winning 14-0 in six innings and 18-0 in five innings in that twin bill down at Motorsports Park in Walla Walla. So Dane Chavez will have a quick discussion with Lenny Ayers, settle him down a bit. Again, coming into the day, Dane Chavez, seven innings pitched, no hits given up, and no earned runs. But so far in this game, giving up five hits and two runs, both earned, as he will now face Race Reeves, the senior center fielder for the Bombers. So he takes strike one on the inside corner for an 0-1 count. Race batting 375, 6 of 16 on the season. And let that one sail above the zone for ball one. Race Reeves leads the team with 9 runs scored. The 1-1 swinging through that one for strike 2 of this current at-bat. So the 1-2 count now from Chavez with no out here in the bottom of the second. And that's low as Racer is gesturing towards Greg Mitchell, wanting him to agree, and he did that time. 2-2 count now on Race. Chavez agreeing with his catcher McClure and delivers the 2-2. Race will put that one in left center field, cut off by Lynn. But not until Race Reeves takes second base, sliding under, and will be in there for a double. An RBI double, scoring Brody Bosick for the third run of the game for the Bombers. So the Bomber bats alive early here in the return trip of this home and home series between the Lions in 2024. Race batting in his 6th run of the season. And Bosick scoring his 4th run of the campaign. Now a runner sits at second base for Carter Uppmeyer as we reach the top of the order for the Bomb Squad. Chavez looks, delivers the 1-0 outside, ball 2. The Bombers already matching their hit total from their first matchup at Roy Johnson Field against the Lions with 6, scoring 3 runs. Chavez steps off and gathers before the third pitch of the at-bat. The 2-0 in there. Fouled away for strike 1. Chavez current sitting at 40 pitches on the evening. 41st on the way, breaking ball in there for strike 2. 2-2 count now on Carter Uppmeyer, junior shortstop. The 2-2. Carter chops that one over to Chavez. Chavez over to Taylor. Doesn't handle it, though. That gets by him. And coming in to score is Race Reeves. And going to second is Carter Uppmeyer, who will score Race Reeves on the error. So 3 runs across here in the bottom half of the second inning, still with no outs. And John Corbin will step back in for the Bombers. John leading off the Bomber hit barrage here with a single to right field in his first at-bat in the first inning. Takes that strike 1. 0-1 count now. So the first error for the Lions. Scores the fourth run. That pitch swung through by Corbin. 0-2 count now on the senior. In the first matchup, the errors were the order of the day. Richland committing 5 in the victory and Kennewick 3 in the loss. The two combining for 2 here early in the ball game. 1-2 count now on Corbin. Breaking ball into the dirt, ball 2 evens this count up at 2. The fifth pitch from Chavez, high and inside, ball 3, full count now for John Corbin. Swinging strike 3, bobbled by McClure though. John will try to beat it out. The throw from McClure lifts the first baseman Taylor off the bag, but in time to get Corbin at first. So Corbin with the strikeout. That'll move the runner up Meyer to third. And we'll bring up Chris Daniels.
Now batting third base number 10, Chris Daniels.
Daniel singling in the first inning as well as he takes that one ball outside. Daniels awaits the 0-1. He'll foul that one off to the right-hand side. For the first strike of the at-bat. Daniel's attending New Mexico State University next season. Daniels takes that one ball inside, high and inside for ball 2. Two one, breaking ball, doesn't break enough into the zone. Ball 3, 3-1 count now on the senior. Chavez, the 3-1, swinging strike 2. Daniel swinging through that breaking ball on the dirt. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Upmeyer still sitting 90 feet away at third. The pitch right back up the middle, off of Chavez's glove, over to Driver. Driver over to first to get Daniels at first, but a run does score in Upmeyer to make the score 5-0 Bombers.
Now batting first base number 6, Dallas Bennett.
Dallas Bennett will dig in for the Bombers. The second at-bat of the ballgame, 1-for-1 on the day. Ball in there for strike 1. Two one count now on Bennett as that ball in the dirt. Bennett 1-for-1 with an RBI as he check swings that time over to first for the check, and they'll say he went. 2-2 now on number 6. Breaking ball chopped over to the right hand side. Taylor grabs it and steps on first for the final out of the inning. 4 runs, 3 hits, 1 error, and no men left on base for the Bombers. They take a 5-0 lead heading into the top of the third here from Bomber Field.
Bombers softball leads Southridge 9-4 in the top of the fourth inning. pitching for the Bombers, number 6, Dallas Bennett. Attention fans, do you have friends and family who want to follow along but can't be here today or live out of town? The game is being broadcast live on YouTube, our best-in-class Atomic TV program. To watch the game, head to YouTube.com and search for Atomic TV and join your tape by the action.
Welcome back to the top of the third inning here from Bomber Field. New pitcher for the Richland Bombers, Dallas Bennett, takes the hill for the Bomb Squad. Two innings pitched for Michael Ravel on 46 pitches, one hit, no earned runs or runs at all for that matter. Two walks and two strikeouts for the sophomore. So Bennett will take the mound for the Bombers as Salisbury will dig in for the Lions. Salisbury with a walk in his first at-bat today. Again, Bennett so far this season, 11 innings pitched, 6 hits, 1 earned run, a .64 ERA, and 10 strikeouts as he delivers a first pitch ball. That one line to center field. Going under it is Race Reeves for out number one. I'll bring up the sophomore Dylan Mamiya for his second AB of the game.
Get over on the right side.
Mamiya fouls that off to the left hand side. Mamiya the 0-1 from Bennett. Bennett breaking ball in there for strike two. Bennett delivers. Swinging strike three, and Mamiya is sat down. And that will be Bennett's 11th strikeout of the season as he sits down the sophomore. Bringing up Brady Mattson, the fellow sophomore for the Lions. Two down just as quickly as they came up for the Lions. Mattson in the box, ball one outside. One hit to left center field from Mattson. Bosick on his horse will not get to it. That'll go to the fence, and Race Reeves will throw it into second with nobody covering. And Mattson will take second base safely to lead off the hitting for, actually register the second hit for the Lions.
Pinch hitting for Kennewick, number 9, Terran Curtis.
Pinch hitting now for Kennewick number 9, Terran Curtis, the sophomore infielder. Only one AB so far on the year. I guess he had one plate appearance and no ABs because he got walked and scored an RBI in that plate appearance. And he takes first pitch strike from Bennett. Ball outside, evens the count up at one. That ball just clipping the inside part of the zone for strike two. And it's a 1-2 count now on Curtis. Swinging through that one does Curtis. And that will end the inning. Curtis striking out from the arm of Bennett. No runs, one hit, no errors, and one man left for the Lions. We go to the bottom of the third. The Bombers will be up leading 5-0. Welcome back to Bomber Field for this Mid-Columbia Conference matchup entering the bottom of the third inning between the Lions and the Bombers. New pitcher for the Kennewick Lions will be Taryn Curtis, the sophomore, number 9. And that will mean Chavez will exit. Dane Chavez, 2 innings pitched, 6 hits, 5 runs, 3 of them earned, 2 strikeouts on 60 pitches for Dane Chavez. He will occupy shortstop now as Taryn Curtis will toe the rubber for the Lions. First batter he'll face for the Bombers will be John Simons. First pitch ball inside from Curtis. Curtis so far 2 innings pitched, 2 hits given up, 1 run was not earned, however, as he struck out 3 on the season. Talk about sophomores occupying the lineup between these two squads. Taryn also a sophomore. Tanner Raines a sophomore for the Kennewick Lions, a young squad for the Orange and Black this season. John takes that ball in the dirt, 2-1 now. Wind picking up a little bit, blowing our camera around here in center field. Should calm down as the sun starts to set. John Simons fouls that off and into the parking lot. 4 strike 2. The 2-2, Simons chops that over to the shortstop, Chavez, and he throws over to first on a hop, and not be able to squeeze it is Taylor, and Simons will reach on error to lead this inning off for the Bombers. So the ball in the dirt, not being able to squeeze it was Taylor to get the first out of the inning, and that puts Simons at first base with Ravel at bat. Michael Ravel 0-for-1 on the day with a strikeout, ending the first inning for the Bombers. That ball high and outside, ball 2. The 2-0 from Ravel in there for a strike. Pickoff attempt over to first base. Simons back in time. Simons with three stolen bases on the year of the Bombers 12 total. And that pitch in there for a ball. And McClure threw it over to third base like it was strike three. Not sure why he was doing that when it was a 2-1 count. Nevertheless, 3-1 count now on Ravel. Ravel takes that ball four. And runners will occupy first and second now for Taryn Curtis. Hayden Galloway steps in for the Bombers. Now 8 of 13 on the season. After his hit in the first inning as he fouls that one way back. Led the inning off in the second with a hard line drive. Resulted in four runs across for the Bombers. That breaking ball breaks. Not quite enough for a strike, so it's 1-1 count now on Galloway. Ball fouled away into the net by Galloway. He wanted that one, as you can see by his reaction. Couldn't quite get enough good wood, so to speak, on it, even though he's using a composite bat. Fouls it away, and we have a 1-2 count now on the sophomore. Pitch from Curtis swung through, and that will sit down Galloway for the first out of the inning. Brody Bosick now stepping in for the Bombers. Galloway, sophomore. Curtis, a sophomore. Now Bosick, a sophomore. Bosick, one for one on the day. That ball getting by McClure off to the right. And now that'll advance each runner 90 feet. Runners at second and third now for Bosick. Watch that ball go into the dirt. 2-0 count now for number nine. Pitch from Curtis. High outside, ball three, 3-0, one out. For Curtis against Bosick. Bosick 3-for-7 now on the season. RBI in the second inning, and that pitch in there for the strike. 3-1 count now. Bosick chops that over to left field side for strike two. Three balls and two strikes now on Bosick. Pitch from Curtis in the dirt, and that will load up the bases full of Bombers. So Bosick taking his first walk of the year, bringing up Race Reeves with three Bombers out in formation for him to hit in with one out here in the bottom of the third. To take strike one from Curtis. Race also with an RBI early in the game, one of four RBI for the Bombers. That ball again in the dirt, inside, ball one. Taren looks over at third and delivers the 1-1. High and outside, ball two. Curtis from the stretch for the 2-1 now. Race takes that inside part of the plate for strike two, 2-2 count. Now on the senior. Ball inside, not catching the plate. 3-2 count now for Race Reeves. Curtis delivers 3-2. That one popped up to the left field side over to the Richland dugout. Hovering over is the third baseman Salisbury, but can't make the catch as it flies into the Richland dugout. We'll reset the 3-2 situation. Three balls, two strikes, one out. Three Bombers aboard. Curtis delivers. That again popped up in foul territory, out of play this time. Race will have a third crack at a 3-2 count. Race looks that one in for ball four, and Curtis will walk in his first run of the season and will make the score 6-0 Richland. Brings out Lenny Ayers as he says some words over to the home plate umpire, Greg Mitchell. Still looking that direction as he comes to talk to his sophomore pitcher. Now gesturing his entire infield into the pitcher's mound. As Upmeyer will be the next Bomber to step in. Steps off the mound. And in steps Upmeyer. Upmeyer 0-2 on the day. He fouls that first pitch off to the right field side. And making the, dropping in fair territory is the ball. And Upmeyer will single and drive in a run, the seventh for the Bombers. Sorry, I couldn't quite see where the ball was going, but it dropped in for a single and makes the score 7-0 Bombers.
John Corbin.
That brings up John Corbin for his third at-bat of the day. Swings at the first pitch, chops it over to third. Throwing to third, McClure just barely steps on the base for out number two as he gets Bosick at the plate. That was Salisbury to McClure at home. Barely getting his cleat onto the front corner of the plate to register the second out of the inning. Corbin will reach on a fielder's choice. Bosick will head back to the dugout. And Chris Daniels will step in.
How about
in
third base number 10, Chris Daniels.
And Chris Daniels will wear that one square between the shoulder blades. And that will bring in the eighth run for the Bombers. As he methodically takes off his gear and assumes his free bag. Lanier is calling to the bullpen to get Curtis out of the game. We'll take a short break as he makes his pitching change. It's the Bombers 8, the Lions 0. Back to Bomber Field as we are still in the bottom of the third inning here with two down and a pitching change for the Kennewick Lions. Taryn Curtis only lasting two thirds of an inning, giving up one hit but three runs cross. One of those was earned as the Lions commit another error in the top of this inning, and Curtis registering three walks and a strikeout on 31 pitches. Lanier is turning to Cameron Owen, the junior. Again, one of their two main arms for the Lions. 13 and two-thirds innings pitch, 18 hits given up. Eight runs, five of those earned. Five walks, a 3.41 ERA, and 10 strikeouts on the season. So he, along with Mamiya, are the two arms for the Lions so far this season. And he will enter this game with two down here in the bottom of the third and bases full of Bombers, trying to stop the bleeding for the Lions. Dallas Bennett will step into the batter's box and try to do the exact opposite, try to continue the Bomber barrage. First pitch from Owen is outside, ball one. Upmeyer at third, Corbin at second, Daniels at first. And Bennett in the batter's box. Pitch from Owen. A ball two. So both of Kennewick's main arms this season, lefties. Mamiya lefty and Cameron Owen lefty. The 2-0 in there for strike one. Bennett 1-for-2 on the day with an RBI. And currently on the bump for the Bombers. That one getting in there, evening up the count at two balls and two strikes here with two down. And again, bases loaded. The 2-2. That one in the dirt. 3-2 count now on Bennett. Runners will be going or taking generous leads, secondary leads, as they're two down. Three-two pitch now from Owen. Strike three as Dallas Bennett gets rung up high and inside, and that will end the inning and the opportunity to score more for the Bombers. So three runs, no hits, one hit, excuse me, and one error for the Bombers. It's 8-0 heading into the top of the fourth here from Bomber Field. Welcome back to Bomber Field here as we enter the bottom of the fourth inning of play between the Lions and the Bombers. Dallas Bennett still on the mound for Richland. That first ball is in the dirt for ball one. Dominic Driver at bat for the Lions. That pitch is outside for ball two. Scoring update from Columbia Playfield. Lady Bombers up 17-4 now over the Southridge Suns at in the top of the fifth inning as Dallas Bennett delivers the first strike of the at bat. Talk about offensive barrage, the Lady Bombers still perfect on the year as they sweep the Southridge Suns. Pitch not hitting quite enough of the plate. Lee, that's an intentional walk. Might have been ball four. Ball four, in any case, walks Driver to first. Chase Taylor now stepping in for the Lions. Ball high over the zone, ball one. Taylor 0 for 1 today. As Bennett delivers ball 2 outside. And Charlie Moody will head out to the mound to talk to his senior pitcher. Chase Taylor 8 of 22, or excuse me. 7 of 22 this season. two doubles and one of four triples for the Lions so far. Bennett takes the rubber again and delivers ball three now to Taylor. Three balls and no strikes. And that will be ball four, four pitch walk delivered by Bennett. And there are two Lions on here with no out.
Now batting, second baseman for Dirk Chavez.
Brings up Dirk Chavez. Currently occupying second base for Kennewick. First pitch is high in there for a ball. Chavez also 0 for 1 on the day. One count now for Bennett. Chavez squares around a bunt. Bennett fields it. He'll throw over to first and they'll call him safe at first as it was not in time. And there are bases loaded now. Bases loaded now for the Lions, but Grant Richardson wants to talk to the field umpire and maybe check on his sophomore first baseman, Ravel, now at first, now that Bennett is on the hill. So a bunt single for Chavez. Base is loaded for Kennewick. That brings up his brother, Dane.
Now batting number two, Dane Chavez.
Dane 1 for 1 on the walk with a walk so far today. Dallas delivers first pitch ball high. Activity down in the Bomber bullpen. Can't quite make out who is warming up for the green and gold, but activity nonetheless. That ball hit well into center field. Going back is Reeves, making an over shoulder. The catch is Reeves and throwing into the shortstop, Upmeyer. That's a sacrifice fly that'll score the Lions' first run of the ball game, making it 8-1. So the first out registered on the fly ball to center. Great play made over the shoulder catch by Race Reeves. But Chavez driving in his fifth run of the season. Dane McClure will step in for the Lions, but after a pitching change for the Bombers. A quick appearance for Dallas Bennett. As the Bombers make a pitching change here, we will step aside. Here with one out in the top of the fourth inning, it's the Bombers 8 and the Lions 1.
Number 12, Bradley Beck.
Welcome back to Bomber Field. Big Columbia Conference Baseball here on Atomic TV. Exiting the game, Dallas Bennett, 1 1/3 inning. One hit, one run. It was not earned. Two walks and two strikeouts for Bennett. 25 pitches and 8 batters faced for Bennett. Entering the game now is Brad Beck.
Now batting number 3, Dane McClure.
He'll face Dane McClure first with runners on second and third and only one down here for the Bombers. Delivers first pitch, chopped, fouled on the left field line. Beck, 3 innings pitched so far on the season, only one hit given up, one walk surrendered, and 3 strikeouts. Again, in only 3 innings of work. Second pitch in front of Galloway. No runners advancing. So a ball and a strike here for Dane McClure. 0-2 today. That pops straight up in the air. Galloway's telling everybody to get away, and he records the second out of the inning. Just what the Bombers needed here in the bottom or the top of the fourth, getting out number 2.
Coming to the plate, number 7, Connor Salisbury.
Bringing up Connor Salisbury for the Lions. First pitch, swinging, strike 1 for Brad Beck. Salisbury also 0-1 on the day. And that pitch getting by Galloway, but popping right back to him off the backstop. I believe that'll go down as a wild pitch. So a 1-1 count now on Salisbury. Salisbury makes contact, hits it over left field side. Chris Daniels scoops and gathers and throws the first for out number 3. So the bases were full of Lions, but only one run crossed home plate as we go to the bottom half of the fourth inning. It's Bombers 8, Lions 1.
Out-of-town scoreboard, a final from Columbia Playfields as Bomber softball defeats Southridge 17-4 to move to 7-0 on the season.
Welcome back to Bomber Fields. We enter the bottom of the fourth inning. The Bombers will be up to bat again, facing Cameron Owen for the Lions, and John Simons will be leading off this inning for the Bombers. That's fine. Simons pops that straight up to second base. Hovering under it is, I was going to say Chavez, but coming in to make the out is Mamiya for out number one.
Bradley Beck.
Bring up Bradley Beck. Now pitching for the Bombers. 1-for-2 on the year. 2 runs scored for the Bombers. So he takes an attack at the first pitch. Fouls into the netting for strike one. After today for the Bombers, the green and gold will travel north for a twin bill in North Richland. And then host Hermiston the Friday of spring break for a twin bill at home. Kennewick Lions have 2 home games, and that ball hits Bradley Beck, and he will take his base. I'm assuming we'll get a courtesy runner here for Brad Beck. Taking off his jersey in the dugout is Luke Parrott, and that's who will come in to run for Brad Beck.
Courtesy running at first base, number 8, Luke Parrott. Now batting catch number 5, Hayden Galloway.
Hayden Galloway now stepping in for the Bombers. Runner on first, 1 out. As Owen hits Bradley Beck to lead off or to put the first runner of the inning on. That one lifted into right field, hovering under it, and making the catch is Mattson, having to deal a little bit with the sun. But he makes out number 2 anyway. That'll bring up Brody Bosick.
How about it? Number 9, Brody Bosick.
So to finish the thought, the Lions will entertain Chiawana for 2 games this Friday. And then the Friday of spring break will be 2 games at Southridge as Bosick makes subtle contact but off of his leg for a foul ball. 2 games on the 5th out in South Kennewick against the Southridge Suns. That's what lies ahead for both of these squads. After this one here in Richland, Owen winds and fires, and Bosick pops that one up in a shallow right center field. Hovering under it, Mamiya, and he'll make the catch for out number 3. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and 1 man left on base for the Bombers. We go to the bottom of the top of the 5th inning. It's the Bombers 8, the Lions 1.
That means time to get out of your seat for a little 5th inning fun.
Back to Bomber Field here on the campus of Richland High School. A little 5th inning fun YMCA as the crowd gets into it here in the top half of the fifth inning of this Mid-Columbia Conference game. Leading off for the Lions will be Dylan Mamiya. He will face Brad Beck for the first time. Beck delivering first pitch ball. And to note quickly that these two managers for both of these schools believe the only matchup of alumni of their respective squads. Lenny Ears, graduate of Kennewick High School, class of 89. Grant Richardson, Richland High School, class of 01. Brad Beck delivers a four-pitch walk to Dylan Mamiya to lead off the top half of the fifth.
How about inning number six, Brady Mattson?
Bring up Brady Mattson. Mattson 1-for-1 on the day. He had a very productive season for him so far. 7-of-14, hitting .500. Quick look over and threaten at first for Mamiya. Mattson doubling earlier in the game. Time is called from Hayden Galloway to go talk to his pitcher, Brad Beck. And warming up in the Bomber bullpen, that's number four, Josh Woodard. The senior warms in the pen. Bradley Beck and Hayden Galloway ending their discussion. And Beck delivering the 1-0. And then for a strike, even this count up at one. Woodard pitched in Walla Walla this past Friday. Two innings under his belt, four strikeouts, no runs or hits surrendered. As now there are two strikes on Mattson. One, two in the dirt. That gets behind Galloway, and Mamiya will take second without threat. And it's a 2-2 count now with a runner on second for Mattson. Brad Beck, the 1-2, or 2-2, excuse me, becomes 3-2. There's a full count now for the senior, delivering to the sophomore, Mattson. The 3-2, swinging, fouled away. Have another 3-2 pitch on the way from Beck. And Beck will hit Mattson. Mattson will take first base with no out here in the top half of the fifth. There's runners on first and second now for Cameron Owen. Grant Richardson heading out to the mound, and that will be it for Bradley Beck. So we'll let the incoming Josh Woodard warm up a bit, and we'll tell you more about this pitching change when we come back here on Atomic TV. Welcome back to Bomber Field and Atomic TV as we have a pitching change here in the top of the fifth with nobody out. Bradley Beck exits the game for the Bombers. Only two-thirds innings pitched. No hits, no runs, and one walk surrendered. Mamiya and Mattson are on board, and those are his responsibility. Now entering the game for the Bombers is number four, the senior Josh Woodard. As I said, when he was warming up in the pen, Woodard two innings pitched so far down in Walla Walla, four strikeouts. And he will face Cameron Owen first in this inning. With two runners on, he'll pick off throws into center field, but no runner advancing. A brief scare there from Woodard throwing the pickoff attempt in the center, but Race Reeves there to back it up and prevent Mamiya from taking third. So the first pitch from Josh Woodard. Low ball. 1-0 count on Owen. Owen, the current pitcher for the Lions, doesn't have any at-bats in today's game thus far. Swings through that pitch from Woodard for strike one. Owen 5-12 on the year. Two RBI, two runs so far, 417 average. As he hits that one to John Corbin's glove at second, and that will be the first out of the inning. Kind of a lazy line drive. Snagged by Corbin for out number one. And that will bring up Dominic Driver for the Lions. So Woodard with one down, still runners on first and second. Takes a look over to Mamiya at second. Wants to pick him off, but not delivered in time. First pitch, the Driver lifted into shallow center field. On his horse is Reeves. He will not get to it as he rifles the throw to third to try to get Mamiya. But not in time, and the bases are loaded once again full of Kennewick Lions. So Driver gets just enough of it to lift it into center. Really no time for Reeves or Upmeyer or Corbin to get a hold of it. It drops in for a single. I'll bring up Chase Taylor to face Josh Woodard. Again with one out, Woodard from the stretch. Taylor lifts that one into left field in foul territory. Making the catch is Bosick, and slipping on his throw. That will enable Mamiya to score, but there are now two outs in the inning. So Bosick registers the second out, and leaving third and scoring for the Lions, Mamiya. And it is 8-2 in favor of the Green and Gold.
All you have to do is ask. You leave early. No. Thank you. No, Dirk.
Grant Richardson wondering if Mamiya left early. Plate umpire Greg Mitchell said he did not. Quick discussion. At bat for Dix Chavez resumes. Pitch by Woodard in there for strike one on Chavez. Chavez 0-2 in today's game. Started out at shortstop while his brother pitched. Has since moved to second base where he normally occupies in the infield. That hit to left center field, gathered by Bosick. Bosick throws to Upmeyer. Upmeyer down to home plate to Galloway, and in time to get the runner Mattson trying to score from second. Great relay from Bosick to Upmeyer to Galloway to end the inning. So one run across, one hit for the Lions, and two left on. As we go to the bottom half of the fifth inning, it's the Bombers 8, the Lions 2. Welcome back to Bomber Field and the campus of Richland High School here for the bottom half of the fifth inning between the Lions and the Bombers.
Richland, center field number seven, Ray.
Leading off for the Bombers is number seven, the senior Race Reeves. First pitch from Cameron Owen, still occupying the mound for the Lions, is in there for a strike. Ball in the dirt for ball one. One on one count for Reeves. He's one for one on the day with two runs scored and two RBI. Takes that one low for ball two. The 2-1 to Reeves, high and outside. That becomes 3-1.
Let's go, Racer!
And Owen delivers the 3-1. That'll be a strike on the outside corner of the zone. Full count, ball four, or full count, 3-2, excuse me. Most of the Bomber fans felt that should have been ball four, but nonetheless, 3-2 pitch from Owen. And that one swung lazily at and fouled away. Popped it over the Bomber dugout to the fence between Franrich Stadium and Bomber Field. And another 3-2 pitch on the way from Owen. Swung on and fouled away again. Race awaits another 3-2. He swings through that one, and that will be strike three. Owen sits down Reeves to start off this inning.
Now batting shortstop number three, Carter Upmeyer.
Bring up the shortstop, Carter Upmeyer. Takes strike one from Owen. One for three on the day is Upmeyer with an RBI and a run scored.
Let's go, Carter.
Facing Owen for the first time. That ball chopped third. Salisbury gathers and throws over to first. That draws the first baseman Taylor off the bag. Bennett reaches and he will take second base on the error. So another error leads to another bomber aboard.
How about in second base number 17, John Corbin.
That'll bring up John Corbin for the Bombers with a runner on second and one out. Third error committed by Kennewick. Matches their error total from the first go around between these two squads at Roy Johnson Field. That ball delivered outside, ball one to Corbin from Owen. From the stretch, Owen delivers ball. Actually a strike at the bottom end of the zone. 1-1 count now on Corbin. Owen the 1-1. Corbin scores around a bunt, pops it up into foul territory, but McClure not quick enough to pop up and out of a stance to make the catch. And there's two strikes now on John Corbin. Delivers, Corbin fouls it away. Looked like Upmeyer might have been trying to take third base there, or just a very healthy secondary lead. But Corbin fouled it away, and we'll see another 1-2 pitch. Owen getting Upmeyer back to the bag. Upmeyer does have two stolen bases on the season. And one of 12 for the Bombers thus far. Corbin gets a hold of that one right back up the middle, and that will bring Upmeyer around third, and he's heading home, and that will be not in time, and Upmeyer will score on the RBI single from John Corbin. Corbin delivers an RBI single, makes the score 9-2 Green and Gold, and brings up Chris Daniels. Corbin driving in his eighth run of the season, tied for the team lead. Much needed positive day in the batter's box for John Corbin. 2-for-4 on the day. RBI and a run scored. Corbin goes and he will take second base, taking his fourth stolen bag of the year. So a runner in scoring position here for Daniels with one strike and one out. Ball in the dirt, evens this count up at one. One-one. Over the zone. For ball two. Daniels 8 RBI on the year, now 10 RBI, including the two in today's game. Trying to add to it here. Watches that ball into the dirt. Ball three, 3-1 count now on Chris Daniels. Owen the 3-1. Ball's outside, and Chris will take first base. I'll bring up Dallas Bennett, and I think that might be it for Owen as manager Lenny Ayers strolls to the pitcher's mound. That will be it. Looks like Mattson will be involved in some capacity. Mattson will move over to second. We will let the new pitcher, I believe, that will be Sam Crowther, take the rubber for the Lions. We'll let him warm up a bit, and we'll be right back here on Atomic TV. Back to Bomber Field here in the middle of the bottom of the fifth. 9-2 Bombers as Samuel Crowther steps on the rubber for the Lions. He takes over for Dirk Chavez. Owen. That was Cameron Owen on the bump. 1 2/3 innings, two hits, one run crossing the plate. One run crossing the plate for Owen. It was not earned, however. One walk and two strikeouts, 35 pitches. They'll bring in the freshman Crowther. 7 1/3 innings pitch, 7 hits, 2 runs, both earned. As he delivers first pitch strike. 2 walks, a 2.54 ERA, and 8 strikeouts. Talked about youth at the top of the broadcast. Doesn't get much younger at the high school level than a freshman. Already throwing 7 innings as he delivers ball 1 to Bennett. Corbin at second, Daniels at first. Crowther looking Corbin's way. So he delivers the 1-1. And ball 2 now to Bennett. Yeah. 2-1. And that's high and inside. Very high and very inside towards Dallas. 3-1 count now on Bennett. And it squares. He pulls back, and strike 2 is thrown by Crowther. So full count now on Dallas Bennett. Runners go. Ball in the dirt for ball 4. As Dallas will take first, and the bases will be again loaded with bombers. Oh. So Crowther walks his third batter of the season. John Simon steps into the batter's box for the Bombers. Corbin at third now, Daniels at second, and Bennett now occupying first base. First big stride to Simons. With one down here in the bottom of the fifth, Simons 0 for 3 thus far on the day. Trying to turn that around here against Crowther, way inside. Ball one. Crowther from the stretch. Simons gets a hold of that, lifts that one in the center field over the head of Mamiya, but he does make the catch. And scoring will be John Corbin on the sacrifice fly to center field, and it's 10-2, Richland Bombers. Now stepping into the batter's box for the Bombers, Josh Woodard, his first plate appearance of the afternoon. To roll into evening time. He swings at the first pitch he sees and lifts it into shallow center field. Mamiya approaching and making the catch for out number three. So one run across makes the score 10-2 Bombers as we head to the top of the sixth here from Bomber Field. Top of the sixth inning here on Atomic TV. Columbia Conference Baseball here between the Kennewick Lions and the Richland Bombers. Josh Woodard still on the mound for the Bombers.
Leading out of the Lions, number two, Dane Chavez.
Dane Chavez will occupy the batter's box first for the Lions. Woodard delivers first pitch strike to Chavez. Chavez 1-for-1 today with an RBI and a walk. Woodard delivers that one in the dirt. Ball one to Chavez. Chavez gets a hold of that one, lifts that one to center field, and Race Reeves will make the catch for out number one. We'll bring up Dane McClure for the Lions. McClure 0-for-3 thus far with a strikeout. Squares around a bunt. Doesn't get it down, though, as that goes off of Galloway's equipment. Yeah. 0-1 the count, so he did foul it off. Woodard delivers the 0-1. 1-1 now to McClure. Ball in there for strike two from Woodard to McClure. Talk about the past two seasons these two clubs have had. As Woodard winds and delivers the 1-2 in the dirt, or just above the dirt, but a ball nonetheless. 2-2 count now. Lions reached the state title game and fell to the Mercer Island Islanders in 2022. 23 wins in that season. 21 wins last season. So that ball is delivered in the dirt from Woodard. 3-2 count now on McClure. So 44 wins the past two seasons for the Lions. And 41 wins the past two seasons for the Bombers. McClure fouls that into right field foul territory and gathered and caught by Dallas Bennett for out number two.
Now batting number 7, Connor Salisbury.
Both two successful past two seasons for both of these schools on the diamond. Connor Salisbury now digs in for the Lions. Salisbury 0 for 2 today with a walk. Salisbury takes that and delivers it to Chris Daniels. Chris Daniels bobbles it a bit, and Salisbury will reach for the first base runner of the inning.
Now batting number 10, Dylan Mamiya.
Dylan Mamiya will now dig in for the Lions. With a runner on and two out. Ball in the dirt, gathered by Galloway well. Pickoff attempt to first, not handled by Bennett. Some discussion between the field umpire and Josh Woodard. Mamiya swings through that one to even this count up at 1. Mamiya lifts that one to foul territory, left side for a strike. So Woodard's got Mamiya in a 1-2 count, now with two outs. Run on first is Salisbury. Mamiya fouls that one into the netting. We'll see another 1-2 pitch from Woodard. Mamiya swings through that one, strike three, and Woodard sits down Mamiya to end the inning. The runner reaches, but no damage done. As we enter the bottom half of the sixth inning, it's the Bombers 10, the Lions 2. Thank you. Welcome back to Bomber Field, and Mid-Columbia Conference Baseball continues here on Atomic TV. Tayden Galloway steps in for the Bombers, facing Crowther, who's still on the top of the mound for the Lions. First pitch is a ball in the dirt. Hayden Galloway gets a hold of that one left field, but hovering under it is Driver to record the first out of the bottom of the inning.
Coming to the plate, number 9, Brody Bosick.
Hit well, but just a little bit too close to Driver, as Bosick will step in now for the Bombers with one down. Bosick gets a piece of that and fouls it away for strike one. Bosick 1-for-2 today. RBI, a run and a walk. RBI was a triple. That pitch in the dirt and away to the short to the backstop, excuse me. One and one count now on the sophomore. Strike two, upper half of the zone to Bosick. The 1-2 now from Crowther. In the dirt, ball two, 2-2 count. Beautiful evening here in central Richland. Baseball being played here since 1945. The 2-2 in the dirt, 3-2. Three balls and two strikes now on Bosick. And he gets rung up for strike three for the second out of the inning.
All right, so good number 7, Race Reeves.
We'll bring up Race Reeves. Two down, nobody on for Crowther. Efficient start to this inning. Delivers first pitch, ball in the dirt. Race gets a hold of that one, lifts it to left field, but again, Driver hovers under it and squeezes it for out number 3. So the Bombers go 3 up and 3 down on the bottom of the 6th. We head to the top of the 7th. The Bombers still leading 10-2.
Pitching to the Bombers, number 10, Chris Daniel.
Welcome back to Bomber Field as we enter the top of the seventh inning. Coming in to pitch now for the Bombers, Chris Daniels. So two innings pitched for his senior counterpart, Josh Woodard. Three hits, no earned runs, no runs at all, as a matter of fact. No walk, and one strikeout, 23 pitches thrown. So Daniels will face the middle portion of the Lion order. And he puts the first runner aboard with a hit by pitch. That was Mattson getting hit by pitch. And that will bring in Maddox Satanu for the Lions. Satanu hitting for Crowther. This is the area where Devin Long occupied early in the game. Pitch in there, ball two. So a three ball start for Daniels. Comes 3-0 on Satanu. Daniels only one inning pitch thus far this season. That strike is delivered. Pickoff attempt to first, not in time to get Mattson. Runner goes, but fouled into the netting. And Mattson will return to first. So three straight balls to begin the at-bat. Becomes a full count on Satanu. Two pitch now from Daniels. Swinging, strike three, and he gets Satanu for the first out of the top of the seventh.
Coming to the plate, number 17, Dominic Driver.
Dominic Driver now will dig in for the Lions. One down and one on here in the top of the seventh inning. Second strikeout of the season for Chris Daniels. Fouled straight back into netting for strike one. A one for Daniels in the dirt, evens the count up at one. Driver one for two tonight. Run scored and a walk. Swings at that one high and inside, but a strike nonetheless. One and two count now on Dominic. Pickoff attempt the first was not in time. Daniels will refocus on Driver. Pitch just high for ball two. 2-2 count now on Driver. Daniels the 2-2 in the dirt. Comes 3-2 and gets away from Galloway a bit. The runner does not go. Three and two now. And strike three, swinging. And down goes Driver for out number two.
Well, we're grateful there are two outs. It's time to get out of your seat. Put your hands together and help us close this one out.
It's coming in a pitch for the Bombers, or for the Lions, excuse me. It is number one, Peyton Moxley, the senior outfielder. One for six on the year so far. He will enter the lineup for Taylor and try to get something going at the bottom of the top of the seventh for the Lions. Strike one here for Moxley. Ball one in the dirt. 1-1 count now on Moxley. Outside, ball two, 2-1. Swings through that one, strike two. Two balls and two strikes. Runner on first for the Lions. Daniel steps off. Step back on the rubber now. 2-2 count and two outs. And that's chopped over to third base. Upmeyer over to Corbin for the final out of the game. Bombers win by a score of 10-2. They improve their record to 8-0 on the season and sweep the Kennewick Lions. Something they have faced the last two seasons, and they give the Lions what they have dealt to the Bombers the past two seasons. So the Bombers improved 8-0. The Lions drop to 7-2 as they will next face the Chiawana Riverhawks again at home at Roy Johnson Field on Friday. The Bombers will head north to North Richland on Friday for a doubleheader as well. 10 runs for the Bombers on 9 hits and 2 errors for the Kennewick, or for the Richland Bombers. The Kennewick Lions only scoring 2, hitting 5, and committing 4 errors to enable the Bomber victory. Winning pitcher on the day will be Michael Ravel. 2 innings pitched, 1 hit, 2 walks and 2 strikeouts, but he gets the victory nonetheless. Losing pitcher will be Dane Chavez. 2 innings pitched, 6 hits, 5 runs, 3 earned, and 2 strikeouts.
We hope to see you there. For more information about Bomber Baseball,
coming up on Atomic TV this week, we have Lacrosse tomorrow at home against Gonzaga Prep, and then again on Friday against the Wenatchee Panthers, and we also have boys soccer over at the Bomber Soccer Field against the Southridge Suns. We thank you for joining us tonight. Again, the Bombers win by a score of 10-2 and improved to 8-0. We'll be back on the diamond two Fridays from this Friday on April 5th. As the Bombers will host a twin bill with the Hermiston Bulldogs. Again, the Bombers win by a score of 10-2. We thanks for tuning in. Good night, everybody.